Hello students, good morning. How are you all? Once again, a very warm welcome to English class. So, I hope you all have been studying properly, nicely, and अच्छे से आप लोग पढ़ाई कर रहे हो and taking care of yourself too, right? So, now we'll be starting with the chapter one of your other book, that is Moments. Okay, so Moments का जो हमारा फर्स्ट चैप्टर है उसको हम आज स्टार्ट करेंगे एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड. इट्स रिटन बाय हु? इट्स रिटन बाय मुल्कराज आनंद. मुल्कराज आनंद, यू नो हु ही वाज? ही वाज एन इंडियन राइटर इन इंग्लिश एंड ही वाज नोटेबल फॉर व्हाट? फॉर हिज डिपिक्शन ऑफ द लाइफ्स ऑफ द पुअर इन द ट्रेडिशनल इंडियन सोसाइटी, वी कैन से. एंड ही वाज द फर्स्ट इंडिया बेस्ड राइटर इन इंग्लिश who got international readership, and he was so notable among the first writers who incorporate Punjabi and Hindustani idioms into the English, and these were some things which made him very renowned and known to all the writers society and as well as to the readers also. So this story basically concentrates on the universality of child's desire for everything. एक बच्चा जो होता है ना उसके अंदर एक यूनिवर्सल अप्रोच होती है कि बच्चे को हर चीज की इच्छा होती है, मुझे ये भी चाहिए, मुझे वो भी चाहिए, मुझे सब कुछ चाहिए. सो सेम यूनिवर्सल फीचर इज बींग टॉक्ड अबाउट. सो दिस इज अ शॉर्ट स्टोरी अबाउट अ चाइल्ड. बच्चा, उसके एस्पायरेशंस, उसकी डिमांड एंड उसके रियलाइजेशंस, ठीक है, तीनों चीजें आएंगी. बच्चा क्या क्या एस्पायर करता है, वॉट डज इट डिमांड एंड वॉट आर हिज रियलाइजेशंस. So this story is mainly focused on the awareness of the parents and messages that we really don't understand the true value of the parents and we just take them for granted. हम जो हैं बहुत बच्चे हैं ऐसे, and randomly I'm saying this, कि बहुत से बच्चे हैं ऐसे जो कहीं पे भी ना बहुत ऐसा हो जाता है that we just do not understand the true value of the parents and we just take them for granted. Now the significance of parents is what is only revealed once they are out of sight. वो कब होता है? It's just revealed once they are out of sight and we realize that the world is upside down. और जब हम ये realize करते हैं ना that world is just upside down, तब हमें जाके ये realize होता है कि अल्लाह कहाँ गए मम्मी, कहाँ गए पापा. So that time we just need our parents. Otherwise हम घूम रहे फिर रहे मस्ती मार रहे, so we just don't realize that they are not near us or we want them or not. So we just take them for granted. So this, that is what the little child realized once he got lost in the fair. And that is why the name of the chapter is what? The Lost Child. The ending is very emotional. Why? Just to keep the readers on guessing whether the lost child would have finally found his parents or not. It was just ki aap bas sochte reh jaoge ki whether exactly he found his parents or not. So it has a very emotional ending and that we are going to see. So this short story goes, we can say, in four parts that we are going to study. One is the happiness of the fair. Ek bacche ko jo happiness milta us fair mein. Second is walking with his parents. वो अपने parents के साथ जब walk कर रहा on the way during his walks, वो क्या क्या चीजें देखता है, उसको क्या मिलता है क्या नहीं मिलता, all these things. And the next is missing of the child. बच्चा खो गया and when he misses, then a stranger tries to console him. Then he meets a stranger who just tries to console him. So these are the four, we can say, the parts that we are going to discuss in this story. So starting with chapter one, the lost child, the text of the chapter goes as follows. A child goes to a fair with his parents. Now this is before you read part. He is happy and excited and wants the sweets and toys displayed there, but his parents don't buy them for him. Why then does he refuse when someone else offers them to him? एक बच्चा जो है वो फेयर में जाता है with his parents and he is very happy and he is very excited and wants the sweets and toys. Now displayed there, but his parents don't buy them for him. वो उसके लिए उसको नहीं खरीदते. Why then does he refuse? फिर वो क्यों refuse करता है when someone else offers them to him? जब वही चीजें जो उसको चाहिए थी और उसके parents उसको नहीं दिला रहे थे. Later everything was offered to him, but he refuses. Why? ऐसा क्यों हुआ? Then why he do refuses everything? What's the basic reason behind that? That very reason we are going to study in this chapter. So see, it was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Some walked, some rode on horses, others sat. Being carried in bamboo and bullock carts, one little boy ran between his father's leg and brimming over with life and laughter. Now, ये स्प्रिंग फेस्टिवल चल रहे थे एंड फ्रॉम द विंटरी शेड्स ऑफ अ नैरो लेन एक वन एली इमर्ज जहां पे एक गेली क्लैड कम्युनिटी ह्यूमैनिटी मतलब गेली क्लैड मींस बहुत हैप्पी एक ग्रुप ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स दिखाई दे रहा था. सम वॉक्ड, सम रोड ऑन द हॉर्सेस, सम वर सिटिंग, सम वर बींग कैरिड इन द bamboo and bullock carts, and there one little boy, he ran between his father's legs, and just he was brimming over with life and laughter. That is it, the life and laughter in his life was overflowing. ठीक है, brim is basically what? Brim is the point जिसके बाद में चीजें overflow होती हैं. We can say his life was full of life and laughter. खुशियों से भरी हुई जिंदगी थी उस बच्चे की. बचपन में सबकी लाइफ भी ऐसी होती है ना, everybody is hale and happy. सब मस्त होते हैं, एकदम खुश होते हैं, बिकॉज नो वरीज, नो टेंशन एट ऑल. सो सी, कम चाइल्ड कम, कॉल्ड हिज पेरेंट्स एज ही लैग्ड बिहाइंड फैसिनेटेड बाय द टॉयज इन द शॉप्स दैट लाइंड द वे. कम चाइल्ड कम, उसके पेरेंट्स ने कॉल किया एंड एज ही लैग्ड बिहाइंड ही वॉज फैसिनेटेड बाय द टॉयज इन द शॉप्स दैट लाइंड द वे. ही वॉज वॉट? ही वॉज जस्ट फैसिनेटेड बाय द टॉयज इन द शॉप्स जो लाइंड था ऑन द वे. He hurried towards his parents. His feet obedient to their call. Now he was, his feet were very obedient to the call of their parents. So he just hurried towards his parents. वो भाग के अपने parents की तरफ गया. His eyes still lingering on the receding toys. उसकी आँखें अभी भी वही receding toys पे. It was just lingering around. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him. जैसे ही वो वहाँ आया उस जगह पे जहाँ पे वो उनके लिए wait कर रहे थे. He could not suppress the desire of his heart. He was just not able to suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. And even though wo kya jante the, he knew the old cold stare of refusal in his eyes. Wo bacche ko pata tha, wo already wo janta tha na, uske hi to parents the. He knew it very well ki jab bhi wo koi cheez mange and how the parents are going to refuse it. वो जो एक रिफ्यूजल का एक कोल्ड स्टेयर उनकी आंखों में नजर आता था ना, वो उस बच्चे को अभी मालूम था. एंड ही न्यू एवरीथिंग अबाउट दैट, उसे मालूम था उस चीज के बारे में सब कुछ. बट स्टिल ही वाज नॉट एबल टू सुप्रेस द डिजायर ऑफ हिज हार्ट. आई वांट दैट टॉय, ही प्लीडेड, ही जस्ट प्लीडेड कि मुझे ये टॉय चाहिए. हिज फादर लुक्ड एट हिम रेड आईड इन हिज फैमिलियर टायरेंट वे. हिज मदर, मेल्टेड बाय द फ्री स्पिरिट ऑफ द डे, वॉज टेंडर एंड गिविंग हिम हर फिंगर टू होल्ड, सेड, Look, child, what is before you now? What happens? जब भी फादर्स को गुस्सा आता है ना, who's there to protect us? Number one, mother. So his father, उसके फादर ने जैसे उस बच्चे ने बोला, I want that toy, his father looked at him red-eyed. और ये बहुत ही उनका वो familiar सा terror वाला way था, जिससे वो हमेशा उसे गुस्से से देखते थे. अब उसकी मदर समझ गई, and she was melted by the free spirit of the day and was tender. And उसने क्या किया, बच्चे को अपना, जस्ट शी गिव हिम हर फिंगर जस्ट टू होल्ड इट एंड सेड, बेटा देखो उधर चलो, व्हाट इज बिफोर यू, देखो वहां पे क्या है. नाउ बच्चों के साथ क्या होता है ना, चिल्ड्रन अगर उनका दिमाग एक चीज पे बहुत जल्दी फोकस होता है ना, इट्स वेरी इजी टू गेट दैट माइंड डाइवर्टेड टू द अदर थिंग. छोटे जो बच्चे होते हैं ना, वो बिल्कुल ऐसे ही होते हैं, उनको आप बहुत जल्दी उनका माइंड जो है अदर थिंग पे आप डाइवर्ट कर सकते हो. द सेम थिंग हैपेंस हियर. अ ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रैगन फ्लाइज वर बसलिंग अबाउट ऑन देयर गॉडी पर्पल विंग्स, इंटरसेप्टिंग द फ्लाइट ऑफ अ लोन ब्लैक बी और बटरफ्लाई इन सर्च ऑफ स्वीटनेस फ्रॉम द फ्लावर. नाउ एक ग्रुप था ड्रैगन फ्लाइज का, इट वर बसलिंग अबाउट ऑन देयर गॉडी पर्पल विंग्स. Now it was just intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or butterfly. वो दौड़ रहा था, भाग रहा था उन butterflies और bees के पीछे. In the air with his gaze. Now with his gaze. Now sweetness. हाँ, in the butterflies और ये जो beetles थे, जो insects थे, bees थी, ये किस लिए भाग रहे थे, किस लिए वो flower to flower move कर रहे थे, just in the search of sweetness from the flower. Now the child followed in air with his gaze. Till one of them would still its wing and rest. Now, bacha jo tha na, was engaged in the air. Wo us titli ke saath saath, us bee ke saath saath, us bacche ki nazare jo thi, wo chal rahi thi in the air. Just wanted to see ki kaise ye ek jo bird hai apne wings ko still karegi and will take rest, and that particular time the child is going to try to catch it. But it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air. But aisa nahi hua, it just went fluttering, flapping into the air. When he had almost caught it in his hand, jaise hi usne almost use caught kar liya in his hand, then his mother gave a cautionary call. To uski mummy ne cautionary call diya, means usko bulaya, come child, come, come on to the footpath. Beta aa jao, come to the footpath, run. And as soon as this call came, he ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while. Wo daud ke apne parents ki taraf gaya, haste khelte, and just walked abreast of them for a while. Being, however, soon left behind, attracted by the little insect and worms along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. Now, the mind keeps on getting distracted. So, as soon as he ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being very soon, however, he was again left behind. Why? Because he was attracted by something else. And now, this time, what was the thing that he was attracted to? Little insects and worms. Along the footpath, move kar rahe the, they were teeming out. Khub sari chintiya, khub sare insects jo the ek saath. They were just teeming out from their hiding places just to do what? Just to enjoy the sunshine. Come child, come, his parents called from the shade of a grove where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. Now on the edge of the well, a grove tha. Grove is basically a place jahan pe khub sare plants hota hai and shady place hota hai. On that particular grove, wahan pe uske parents jo the, they were sitting on the edge of the well. And they just call him, come child, come. And he ran towards them. Aur wo bhag ke unki taraf gaya. A shower of young flowers fell upon the child as he entered the grove. Jaise wo bachcha us grove mein enter hua na, there was a shower of flowers, young flowers. And forgetting his parents, wo bachcha parents ko bhi bhool gaya. He just began to gather the raining petals in his hand. Insects ko bhi bhool gaya, parents ko bhi bhool gaya. Now the mind is diverted to what? It is diverted to the raining petals of the flowers. And he just began gathering them in his hands. But lo, he heard the cooing of doves and ran towards his parents shouting. But lo, what he heard? Now the next thing happens is he heard the cooing of the doves. And he ran towards his parents shouting, wo chillata gaya, the dove, the raining petals drops from his forgotten hand. Aur jaise hi uska dimag doves pe gaya na, he just forget about the petals that he has gathered in his hand. So the dove, dove, he shouted, and the raining petals, it just dropped from his forgotten hand. Come child, come, they called to the child. The parents ne fir se bulaya, aajao beta, aajao. Who had now gone running in the wild capers round the banyan tree. Jo abhi bhagta hua kahan gaya tha? Gone running in the wild capers round the banyan tree. And gathering him up, they took the narrow, aur unhe ikattha karte hue, they took the narrow winding footpath. Wo us narrow winding footpath ki taraf gaya, which lead to the fair through the mustard seed fields. Aur wo footpath which led to the fair, jo mele ki taraf ja raha tha, but it was going through what? The route was through the mustard fields. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by confusion of the world he was entering. And as they neared the village, child jo tha na, could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. Now, confusion of the world is what? Now he is able going to see so many things, different things, and he is at times he is going to get attracted by so many things. But usme se usse kya milta hai, kya nahi milta, and what is basically the sequence of the things that he keeps on seeing and getting attracted to is as follows. A sweet meat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance. Now the first thing, as soon as he entered the fair, what he saw? सबसे पहले रास्ते में चलते उसने टॉयज देखे, एंड आफ्टर द टॉयज नाउ कम्स व्हाट? अ स्वीट मीट सेलर. अ स्वीट मीट सेलर वाज हॉकिंग व्हाट? वो क्या बोल रहा था? गुलाब जामुन बेच रहा था, रसगुल्ले थे, बर्फी थी, एंड द जलेबी. वेयर एट द कॉर्नर ऑफ द एंट्रेंस, एंड जो क्राउड था ना, इट प्रेस्ड राउंड हिज काउंटर एट द फुट ऑफ एन आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ मेनी कलर्ड स्वीट्स डेकोरेटेड विद लीव्स ऑफ सिल्वर एंड गोल्ड. Now at the corner of the entrance, यहाँ पे crowd जो था, it just pressed around this corner at the foot of an architecture of many colored sweets decorated with just leaves of silver and gold. The child stared open-eyed and his mouth watered for the barfi that was his favorite. And bacha jo tha, it just stared open-eyed, aankhe khulli, mouth watered, just for what? For barfi, which was his favorite sweet. I want that barfi, he slowly murmured. उसने धीरे से बोला, कुछ फुसाया, क्या बोला वो? मुझे बर्फी चाहिए. But he half knew that as he begged that his plea would not be heeded because his parents would say he was greedy. वो हालांकि half he knew कि he has begged his plea for the barfi, but ऐसा होगा नहीं. It's not going to be paid any attention to and it is going to be refused. बिकॉज उसके पेरेंट्स ये सोचते हैं कि ये बच्चा है ना, ये बहुत लालची है, जब भी कोई भी चीज देखता है ही जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू ईट इट, उसको वो खानी होती है. वाई सो? सो नहीं. सो विदाउट वेटिंग फॉर एन आंसर ही मूव्ड ऑन, उसका मन हुआ, उसने बोला, बट विदाउट वेटिंग ऑन फॉर एन आंसर ही जस्ट मूव्ड ऑन. एंड एज ही मूव्ड ऑन, नेक्स्ट व्हाट ही कम्स अक्रॉस, a flower seller hawked a garland of gulmohar, a garland of gulmohar. The child seems irresistibly drawn. He went towards the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, I want that garland, but he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers because they would say that they were cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Now flower seller was hawking what? A garland of gulmohar, a garland of gulmohar. और ये जो बच्चा है ना, इट सीम्स इररेसिस्टिबली ड्रॉन, ये बच्चा जो था बहुत ही इररेसिस्टिबली ऐसा लग रहा था, इट्स जस्ट ड्रॉन टुवर्ड्स दैट पर्टिकुलर फ्लावर गार्लैंड. एंड ही वेंट टुवर्ड्स द बास्केट, जहां पे वो फ्लावर जैसे हीप में पड़े थे. एंड ही हाफ मर्मर्ड, मुझे ये गार्लैंड चाहिए, आई वॉन्ट दैट गार्लैंड. बट वो बहुत अच्छे से जानता था दैट हिज पेरेंट्स वुड रिफ्यूज टू बाय हिम दोज फ्लावर्स, दैट हिज पेरेंट्स आर डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू रिफ्यूज हिम टू बाय दोज फ्लावर्स बिकॉज दे वुड से दैट दे वर चीप, क्योंकि वो क्या बोलेंगे, दैट दे वर चीप, की ये तो बहुत ही चीप सी चीज है. सो विदाउट वेटिंग फॉर एन आंसर ही मूव्ड ऑन, बिना आंसर का वेट किए व्हाट ही डिड, ही जस्ट मूव्ड ऑन. A man stood holding a pole with yellow, red and purple balloons flying from it. Now the next thing is balloon. ठीक है, a man who was standing holding what? Holding a pole which was having yellow, red, green and purple balloons all were flying from it. Child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors. बच्चा जो था ना, वो simply carried away by what? The rainbow glory of the silken colors. And he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. And he was just filled with an overwhelming desire just to possess them all. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloon because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. Now, but what happens? But he well knew, वो जानता था that his parents are never going to buy him these balloons because उनका क्या कहना है that वो बहुत बड़ा हो चुका है, now it's not his age to play with the balloons because they would, क्योंकि वो ऐसा कहेंगे. Now next comes what? Because they would means वो जानता था that his parents are going to say the things, same things to me. ठीक है, so what he did? So he walked further. तो वो जानता था कि ऐसा ही होना है, so he just walked further. And now next who comes? A snake charmer. Snake charmer, जानते हो क्या होता है? सपेरा. Now snake charmer stood playing a flute to a snake which coiled itself in a basket. Now this snake charmer just stood playing the flute. वो बांसुरी, वो बीन बजा रहा था अपनी, because which coiled or to the snake. वो बीन किसके लिए बजा रहा था? वो उस snake के लिए जो स्नेक कॉइल करके बैठा था इटसेल्फ इन द बास्केट. एंड इट्स हेड रेज्ड इन अ ग्रेसफुल बेंड लाइक द नेक ऑफ द स्वैन. एंड उसका जो हेड था ना, बहुत ही ग्रेसफुल बेंड में जो था, इट वाज रेज्ड लाइक द नेक ऑफ अ स्वैन. आपने देखा होगा कि सांप जब बिल्कुल बैठता है अपना फन फैला कर, तो वो बिल्कुल वैसे बैठता है जैसे आपने स्वैन को देखा होगा, है ना? तो बिल्कुल उसी तरह से. वाइल द म्यूजिक स्टोल इन टू इट्स इनविजिबल ईयर्स. अब स्नेक के जो ईयर्स होते हैं वो हमें दिखते नहीं है, इनविजिबल है. बट वो जैसे ही वो म्यूजिक उसके इनविजिबल ईयर्स में गया, लाइक जेंटल रिपलिंग ऑफ एन इनविजिबल वाटरफॉल, जैसे एक बहुत ही जेंटल वाटरफॉलिंग की साउंड आती है ना, एट दैट पर्टिकुलर वाटरफॉल विच इज इनविजिबल, द चाइल्ड वेंट टुवर्ड्स द स्नेक चार्मर. वो बच्चा स्नेक चार्मर के पास गया. Now, but knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such coarse music as the snake charmer played, he proceeded further. एक बार तो वो वहां चला गया, but then he just knew कि उसके parents ने उसे मना किया था that he they have forbidden him to hear such coarse, such rough and bad, unpleasant music as the snake charmers played. So he just proceeded further. As there was a roundabout in full swing. Now next comes the roundabout. Men, women and children carried away in a whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. The child watched them intently and then he made a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. Now there was a roundabout in full swing. Now what happened? Men, women and children, they all were carried away in a whirling motion. Now shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. Bachcha jo tha khada dekhta raha, watched them intently. And then he made a very bold request. And usne kya bola? I want to go on that roundabout, please father and please mother. Okay, so I hope this is well explained to you and you just go through it, students. I hope you will be able to understand it. So till here, what we have seen many attractions in the fair for a child, like sweets, balloons, toys, many eatable things, snake charmer, merry-go-round and many things. Now child asks for these things from his parents, but their parents, they do not have any desire to buy these things for the child. So child is thick, crowd is very thick and parents know how to move through it. So holding the hand of the child, they just move. So on different stages, different steps, the child is attracted by different things. But now, further what happened, what is further we can say, what's the ending basically, that whether he gets everything or if he does not get, then what actually happens. So this we are going to study in the next part. For today's part, just go through it well and I hope you will be able to understand it nicely. Okay, so just take care of yourself and we'll be meeting in our next class. Till then, keep studying.